Hi everyone, this is Kalyan Kumar and welcome to my channel Product Reviews. In this channel, we review various products, especially those that I've been using for quite some time and the ones in which I have worked a lot, using which I have done a lot of work, and that has probably given me more insight into these devices, where all they can be used, what are their shortcomings, and that is exactly what we do in this particular channel. And today I bring you a new device. It's called the Wacom DTH-2242. Now this device, of course, was released about 5 years back, but this device is a very, very unusual and very unique device. And I've used it for more than 2 years. I'm a teacher and I've used it in my classroom. And believe me, the kind of work I'm able to do with this is amazing. So let me first of all introduce you to the device and let me tell you what all it does, give you an overview of what all it can do, and then we'll talk about its specifications. We'll also talk about where all it can be used and when it can be used. As you can see, this is the device. So let's zoom in on this. This is the device and this is a 21.5 inch IPS display. So the diagonal that you see here is an IPS display of 21.5 inch. And this is a monitor. Now, this particular device has a resolution, an HD resolution of 1920 by 1080. So you can get an HD display on this. Now, it's only a display unit. What you need to understand is it's only a display unit. It is like any other monitor of your computer. So if you have a desktop PC, you have a CPU connected to a display and you can change the display, you can have a smaller display, a flat screen, and you can have bigger displays. So this is basically a display unit. It doesn't have any processor in it. It doesn't have any CPU built in it or a RAM built in it. It is basically a display unit. But the most important part of an unusual part of this display is that this is a multi-touch display. What it means is, if you connect this to your laptop, and I've done that, or you can connect it to your CPU of your desktop, it will mirror your screen. When you connect it to the laptop, it mirrors the screen. If you connect it to your CPU of your desktop, it becomes the screen. And this is a multi-touch screen. So even if your laptop, for example, does not have the touch input in it, that means you can only use the keyboard and the trackpad, this display will make it a touch unit. So you can touch on this display and make things work just like you would do it on a touch display. The second part of it is, if you connect it to your CPU, and let's even say that you have Windows 7 or you have Mac. Now this can be connected to either of the two machines and it becomes touch. So imagine working on a Mac display, Mac being displayed on this, and using the touch functionality. So you can touch each icon, you can pinch to zoom, you can do all those functions that you probably do with a touch interface. So that's one of the most important parts about this particular display. Now, the advantages of this over a normal touch unit is, it's a pen display. This is the Wacom pen. If you can zoom in on this. This is the pen that I'm going to use. And I can write on this. I can write on the screen itself. Now, this is a 21.5. So almost something very similar to what you have as the Microsoft Studio. The one that is recently launched. Now, that's a complete device in itself. It's all in one. But this becomes an all-in-one when you connect it into a computer. And this pen is, it has a pressure sensitivity of 1024. So it can, if you press harder, give you a thicker line, press lighter, gives you a thin line. Of course, I wouldn't recommend it for artists, because for artists, you have the Cintiq line, the Cintiq HD line, where you have a pressure sensitivity of more than 6000, which probably is what artists need to draw. But this has 1024, and I use it in my classroom. In fact, I have been using it in my classroom for almost 2 years, and then I switched over to Wacom Cintiq Companion, about which we'll discuss in the next video. So let's go ahead and talk about this again. But this pen, in fact, let's talk about this pen. This pen is unique because it doesn't have any battery inside. Unlike the pens that you see in Microsoft Surface Pro or Microsoft any particular device that you have, Surface Book for that matter, all those pens need a battery, a AAA battery. Some require one, some require two. And in fact, almost all manufacturers are making pens which have cells in them. This one does not have any battery. The moment it comes near the screen, it is automatically detected by the screen. So this is the Cintiq, this is the DTH-2242. In fact, if you can zoom in on this particular box, this is the box in which it came in. And it's, you can see the, it's written DTH-2242. It's called Interactive Pen Display. So I can make my laptop into a pen tablet. Now, and of course, once I discuss all the things that we can do with this, we'll also discuss the cons of this. And now let's talk about the tablet, the display unit, and how all we can tilt it. The tilting angle of this particular display is ranging from 15 degrees to 72 degrees. I personally feel that for writing something, as we usually write in a piece of paper, we keep it, the paper is almost horizontal, completely horizontal, and then we write it. So it's much more easier to tilt it back at an angle of as low as possible. 15 degrees, perfectly fine. In fact, this is slightly higher than 15 degrees right now that I've kept. And it is much easier to write in this particular angle than if it is at 72. So in 72, perhaps if you're just standing and you want to just make an annotation, you can probably do that. But in a proper writing, you would probably need it at an angle of 15 degrees or slightly higher. So that is important about this. Now let's talk about the connectivity. How is it connected to your laptop? And then after that, I'm going to switch it on and I'm going to show you how it mirrors the display, how there does a touch work, and how I'm going to use the pen to write. Now it connects using this cable. There are two connections, in fact. One cable is this one. This is a normal VGA cable, if you can see. And this is called the DVI cable. Now there's a DVI port in and a DVI port out. There are two DVI ports in this. So you connect this, the white one, to the DVI in of this, and connect the VGA cable to your laptop or to your CPU. Now, most of the laptops that you get these days don't have a VGA port. So you probably would have a display port, a mini display port. And as you can see, I have used a mini display adapter here. It's an Apple mini display adapter, and it is having female VGA at one end. So what I've done is I've connected this blue cable, this VGA cable to the female of this, and the white one to the DVI in of this. And I'm going to show you later on the back side of this. So this is how the connection is done. The second connection that you need, now this only helps in mirroring the display. This only shows you whatever is there on your laptop screen is shown here too. But what you also need to do is you need to enable the touch in this. You need to make sure that whatever interaction I do here, that interaction occurs in the computer. So for that, we use what is known as a USB cable. So we have a USB cable and a different type of port at one end, but then that cable you anyway get along with this particular device. You don't get this, by the way. This is something that you need to purchase outside. Whereas the USB cable you get, there's a USB port, and you connect it to the USB port. And the other end is a very special kind of a port, which is connected at the back side of this. And it is that transmits information of touch from this to the laptop or the CPU. So this is the basic connection that we generally have. If you zoom in on this part, it may be a little difficult. There are five buttons on top. These buttons are customizable. The most beautiful thing about Wacom, there are two very, very important things about, rather three very, very important things about Wacom products. The first is, whatever stand that they have, those stands don't vibrate. For example, look at this. I'm trying to push it. It's hard. It doesn't get pushed. If you look at the Microsoft Surface Pro or all the clones of Surface Pro 4 that you generally have, the ThinkPad X1 tablet from Lenovo and the Dell XPS 12.2, the recent one, all of them, in fact, the Dell part that does not even have a kickstand, but all those that have a kickstand, the Acer and all the Acer, the Asus, all these tablets that you have with a kickstand, they vibrate. So when you keep your hand in that, they keep going back and forth, and it's difficult to write in that. But look how sturdy this is. I'm pushing it, it's not moving back. That's one of the biggest thing about Wacom. The second thing about Wacom products that I love is that the fact that the pen doesn't have a battery. Most, or rather I would say, because I have not used all the products of Wacom, I think almost all the products of Wacom, all the pens, they come without a battery. So there's no need to change battery, figure out whether you have a battery or not. You got the entire thing set up and suddenly you realize the battery is not there, or the battery stopped working. So you don't have that issue with this thing. And the third most important thing and the beautiful thing about Wacom products is that these products come with a touch on and off. Meaning I have a dedicated button here, in fact I can customize it, which will turn the touch on and touch off. So when the touch is on, then my fingers can also create touch. But when the touch is off, I can only interact with the pen. That means I can keep my hand here. The palm rejection is not required, though it comes in with an inbuilt palm rejection also. But palm rejection is not successful 100%. There are always situations when you just, you know, stroke your finger and there's always some kind of a mark being left there. Whereas with this, you have no issue. You can hold it with one hand, write it with the other. You can have as many fingers touching it. The touch is off, only the pen will interact. So writing becomes even more smoother. And there are no issues. There's nothing that goes wrong in doing this. So that's the beauty of this particular product. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to switch on and I'm going to show you how this mirrors this, and then we'll bring the camera a little bit closer to show you how I use this and how I write on this. So I'm switching it on. It's already connected to my laptop. As you can see, my laptop, and this has mirrored the display. It's display mirrored. Whatever you see in the laptop, you see here, and it's a bigger screen. So I'm going to talk about the details of this. Let me bring the camera a little bit closer, and then we'll talk about how the touch works and how the pen works. Welcome back, and now you can see the display. It has mirrored my laptop. Everything in my laptop is there, and this is the button. If you can show the button. This is the button which I have customize. You can customize all the five buttons. Customize for touch on, touch off. So if I touch on, if I press this touch on, now this is completely touch sensitive. So I'm just pressing the Chrome button and you can see this. I can minimize this. I can open any of these. I can open the screen recorder that I generally use for my videos. For my video recording, this is Camtasia, and I can touch it and make it go back. So let me perhaps show you something else. This is Audacity. I press it twice, works just like any other touch device. And this is Audacity opened up now, and I can switch it off with my touch. When I do the touch off, nothing works. It's not touch now. So that's the advantage. You can keep your hand and then you can write. But look at the fact, it since, can you see the arrow? Just see the arrow as my pen is moving. So it is detecting the pen, but not my finger touch, which is exactly what I want. And if I want, I can use the pen to open up the browser now. I can use the pen to close the browser now. But if I press my finger, it doesn't work. The touch is off, which is a great thing. In fact, if this thing were in Surface products, it would make them even more greater than what they already are. Another advantage of this display is it has got two USB ports on the sides. That means they act as USB hubs. So if your device, because this already uses up one USB port of your laptop, and these days the laptops, as you know, they come with very, very poor connectivity issues. They have only one USB, sometimes just barely two USBs, but you have two additional USB on this. So if you want to attach anything using a USB, you can attach them here. It works just on the computer because there is a cable that connects the data of these two. So now I'm going to tell you how I write, how I use this. Now I use this in my classroom. What I do is I connect it to my laptop. And as I said, it has a DVI out also. It has a DVI in and a DVI out. In the DVI out, I connect that to my projector. One end of this white cable connects the DVI out and the blue cable connects to my projector. So what happens is, I can project this entire thing on the screen. So this is mirrored here and this is mirrored on the projector. Now how does it help? Well, what I do is, I initially used to teach while standing just like any other teacher, but as the number of classes grew, I used to feel a lot of pain in my feet, and therefore I decided to use a device that I could use while sitting. So what I did initially, I used document cameras, but then there were a lot of diagrams and I'm not great in writing. In fact, my handwriting is awful. My drawing is even more awful, and therefore I wanted to use something where I could, you know, use technology and use built-in shapes. So what I did, of course you can use OneNote, you can use any whiteboard software. I've got Smooth Draw here, I've got a lot of whiteboard software, but of all of them, I found PowerPoint to be the best. You can use OneNote also. Some people find OneNote much more easier. You can use that, not an issue. And this is how I use the PowerPoint. This is my PowerPoint. And as you can see, I hope you can see this, that there are a lot of lines in this. There are a lot of lines because I have a tendency to not write in a straight line. So I have a tendency to go up. My handwriting is such that if there's a plain sheet of paper, I start from lower down and go up irrespective of how much I may try. It keeps doing like that. So I've drawn some lines in this just like a ruled notebook, and I'm able to write in this. So I'm going to show you how I write in this. I've customized all those things, and you can customize that in Microsoft Office. I've customized that all on top. And now I'm going to write and show you. I'm going to select the pen thickness. See, this is the advantage. You can write softer, you can write harder, you can have a thick line, you can have a thin line. And I say, hi there, how are you? See my handwriting, how bad it is? But then the fact of the matter is, I'm able to sit and write. And the best part of this is, the students, of course, have an issue because they have to see the screen and they have to see the teacher, and there are two different positions, but over a period of time, they get used to it. And the advantage is that when I write the entire stuff, I convert that into a PDF and send it to them. So even if they don't copy whatever I've written, they're not able to do that, I send this to them. Another advantage, well, whatever I write, I do the screen recording of that. So the screen gets recorded along with my voice, and I send that video to YouTube, give them a private link, and they are able to see my entire video here. So this fellow is open, I think. Let me close this. So this is how I use a pen. And there's another advantage of this. If you want a particular figure, since I'm using PowerPoint, well, I can draw a hexagon. Doesn't take much time. So I can draw basic shapes which otherwise I would have drawn very badly. They're already there, and it just takes a few seconds to draw them. Of course, one thing that you must always keep in mind when you use this kind of a device is that you must have a keyboard with you. Now, right now, since the distance of the laptop and this is pretty small, I can use the keyboard shortcut here. I can use delete and things like that. But what I've also done is, when I was using them in my classroom, my podium was not big enough to accommodate these two because this is pretty huge. So this used to be at a distance from this, and I was not able to use the keys here. So what I would do is, I would customize these to the most important keys that I need, like delete. And the pen, as you can see, has two knobs here, two switches here, the top switch and a bottom switch. And I have customized this. The top switch is my shift, and the bottom is my control. So I can use control and then press something, it would behave the same way as I would have done it in my keyboard. Or else what you can do is you can keep a small keyboard here that is connected wirelessly or maybe with a wire to your laptop if your laptop is at a particular distance. A keyboard really helps a lot. And then of course there is an eraser. You can erase everything. So in a document camera, what used to happen is you write on a pen or on a sheet of paper, and then if you want to erase it, you can't erase it, you have to cut it out. And in a board, using different inks, different colors, it's not that easy, and you have a highlighter here. For example, let me write something. Hi, how are you? And then I can go up here, use a highlighter, and just highlight this. You can't do that on a board. You can do that here. Technology really helps a lot. And then you can just erase it. And another advantage is sometimes, you know, I miss out a few words. I say how, and I forget to use the word are. And perhaps, of course, here I've given a space. Let me say I don't give a space here. Let me say I say how you. And I realize, oh my God, what do I do with the R? Now, the one thing is I try to show an insertion here or I erase this, but well, computer, there's a lasso tool. I can select my U separately and then I can drag the U a little forward and then I go back to my pen and say, how are you? So I can use specific words and drag them separately to separate pieces. That's the lasso tool in the pen tablet, and that's the beauty of Microsoft Office. Especially, I mean, for me, I've been using PowerPoint for almost 10 years now, so I'm very comfortable with this, so I prefer to use this. And another beautiful thing that I want to show you, of course, this is not about just the tablet, it's about PowerPoint, but you know, I can't resist the temptation of showing you that it has some shapes which can be drawn without having to pull them from the PowerPoint itself. For example, I'm going to draw a circle. Look at this. I'm going to draw a circle. It becomes a perfect circle because I just can't draw a circle. Let me say I'm drawing a triangle and look how awful it is. So, but if I draw a little bit carefully, it becomes a perfect triangle. Hey, how about a hexagon? I want to draw a hexagon here. See how bad it is? It's a pentagon now. Because five sides. I want to draw a hexagon. Hexagon. So this is the beauty of this. And you want to remove all of them? Well, if you have a tablet here, I mean, if you have a keyboard here, delete all of them and that's it goes there. And therefore, what you can do is you can do multiple things on this. You can put colors on shapes. You can change the shapes. There are so many things. And of course, another beauty I want to show you. Yeah. So let me just deselect this. Is the touch off? Oh, okay, touch is off. That's fine. All right. Now, suppose you want to convert your handwriting into a text. How do you do that? There are softwares built in, but one of the beauty of Microsoft Windows is that you can do it so well here. What I do is I just select a text box, open a text box. The moment I open a text box, there's a cursor already blinking there. I go to the keyboard here. This is the keyboard built into Windows. And as you can see, there's a last button here, English. I'll just show you that, English. So I press this and you can see there is a pen marker here. I tap this. Now I get two lines. I need to write it. Welcome to my channel, product review, and just put insert. Your handwriting converted to text. And that you can do without having a pen that can work on your laptop. You can use a pen of this Wacom tablet. So now I'm going to show you the ports at the back and how you can incline it forward and backward, how you can adjust various angles, and what are those ports from which you do the connection with the laptop. So here is the back side of the display unit, and in this display unit you can notice there are two DVI ports. There's one DVI port here and another DVI port here. The top DVI port, now this is the power switch, a normal power adapter. This is the power brick, and you connect it to your power, normal power, and there are two DVI ports. As you can see, the top one is the output and the bottom one is the in port. So the one that comes from your laptop goes into the in part, and the one that goes to your projector or an external display goes from the out part. And if you can notice, there is a small port here. This is where the USB cable gets attached. So one end of the USB cable, in fact, let me show you that cable if I can. I can show you how it looks like. One end of the cable is USB, the normal USB. It's USB 2.0. And the other part is this, the one that, you know, generally it gets used in printers. So this is the other part. This gets connected to the last port here. And this is the one that transfers data to and fro from the monitor to the computer and back. And on the side here, I think it's a bit difficult for you to look at this one. If you can see this one, there's a USB port here. And a similar USB port is on the other side. So it also has two USB ports which can be attached. You can attach any device to this, a hard drive, a pen drive, a camera, you can do anything. And the best part about this device, how I use this device, is I use it in the classroom, and the advantage is I can face the students and then write. Generally what happens as a teacher, when you turn your back, the students, you know, they get distracted. So here I'm sitting in front of the students, the display unit is with me, and everything is happening on the screen. So they look at the screen and then they look at me when I'm trying to explain something. So this is a wonderful way of teaching. The downside, as I said, we'll also look at the cons. There's only basically one downside, I would say. It's very bulky, huge, not portable. It weighs about 6.5 kgs. So it's not easy to carry this, it's not portable. So if you put it in a particular classroom, it's difficult to, you know, sort of manage removing it, uncabling it, and then going to the next classroom, doing it again. It's not that easy unless and until you have a help for doing that. But otherwise, this is a wonderful unit. So what the Wacom did, they produced this one the first, but then they realized the portability issue. Now, the portability issue was solved by having a smaller one. They also have a 14-inch one. But believe me, the 22-inch with this 21.5-inch display is far, far superior to the 14-inch. Because you can actually see there's a lot of landscape. You can also see, you can see a lot of view. And so I think this works much better. But it is bulky. And this is how you change the angle, you know. There's a switch here. I press this and this can move back and forth, and right now I press this and see, it has come here. This is the 15 degree angle, and go back 72 degree angle. So if you want to stop somewhere in between, I press this lever, bring it here and stop, and it works here. And since this is the part which is down, see, it doesn't go down. And that is why the Wacom devices are far superior to other pen devices, because they are actually meant for writing and drawing. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and please do not forget to subscribe to this channel. And once you subscribe, you'll get all product videos information, and you'll get up-to-date information whenever I upload a video. So thank you for watching.